So in the studio today, we have with us Steve Walker, founder of Ahoy Boats and Sculling Academy, and author of How to Win, The Sports Competitor's Guide to Success. And so Steve, I believe that you are a bit of an expert on physiology and psychology and somatotypes, and you may have some solutions for the National Health Service and the obesity crisis. We all know that diets don't really work. I've known through the coaching courses that I've been on that lightweight women who diet down each year to try and get to the weight in rowing, the next year they're a bit heavier and it's harder to get down to weight, and the next year they're a bit heavier again and it's harder again to get down to weight. In other words, diets don't work because of the starvation reflex, the famine reflex. What does that mean? If you starve yourself, then the body's natural reaction when it gets some food is to say, ha ha, we better store as much of this as we possibly can so that we, you know, survive. And another repercussion of dieting like that, intermittent dieting, is that you become more susceptible to osteoporosis. So there are a lot of problems associated with dieting, and overeating, of course, there's a lot of problems there. We all know diabetes and obesity has a lot of repercussions. And just dieting is only part of the equation. You need to change your diet rather than just go on a diet. And all these fad diets don't really work very well. And you need to exercise. Now, for most people, exercise is like a punishment. If you say to an obese or a fat person, you need to get down to the gym and work out, that they're immediately they imagine, you know, some personal trainer standing over them with a whip and sweat pouring off them and, you know, being in agony. Well, you know, this is not the culture that we want to create. So what do you propose then, Steve? Well, exercise has to become a joy. It has to be something that you look forward to and relish rather than something you dread. And that's where my sport comes in. I go sculling. I go sculling, that's rowing with an oar in each hand. And I go sculling pretty well every day. And nobody could accuse me of being obese. I've been lucky like that. I could have been obese when I joined the Royal Navy and stopped exercising, because I don't lay much emphasis on exercise in the Royal Navy, because the fat people survive if you sink and the thin people don't survive. So there wasn't really a culture of exercise in the Royal Navy, and after a few months of eating four meals a day and not exercising, I put on about 15% of body weight. Fortunately, I caught myself in hand, and I now am not obese, but I could easily have been. My father was a plump man, but when he was a young man, he was fit like I am now. You look in pretty good shape, Steve. Do you mind asking how old you are? I was born in 1950, so you can do the maths. Goodness me, that's remarkable. So you say you compete. What sort of level do you compete at? There are masters competitions all over the place, and domestic competitions, international competitions. I race at the highest level I can to test myself, and race at international masters regattas and national masters regattas, and I do all right. Come on, Steve, you're being a bit modest here. Do all right? What does that really mean? Well, I won at the World Masters Regatta in my single in 2012 in Duisburg. Wow, that's amazing! And then I won again in Copenhagen last year in my single, and also in a double with my training partner. Wow, a mixed double. That's amazing. So, like I say, I do all right. But I thought you had to be big to be a successful rower, like Steve Redgrave. Oh no, that's a common misconception put about by big people, I think. But it dates back to when boats were heavy, and coxed boats in particular, where it was an advantage to be big. But now with the coxless boats and lightweight carbon fibre boats, it isn't necessary to be big. You just have to be good. Getting back to the exercise thing, you have to want to exercise. And I get tremendous joy from sculling every day, going out on the river. It's completely different from rowing on a machine in a gym. Completely different. They're poles apart. Time just flies by. It's easy to go sculling or rowing for an hour and a half, and it's torture to do that on a machine. So this is the solution, is to be able to go rowing every day. Now, of course, this isn't a solution for everybody. Not everybody has access to a river or a lake or the sea to go rowing in. And if you're obese, well, if you take a look at the boats in the average rowing club, you only have to take one look at them and you think, well, I couldn't possibly row in that. That's just impossible. How do people ever row them? But I wouldn't even fit in it. And so that's this is my solution, is that I have now got a boat to promote which has the capacity to accommodate up to 250 kilograms. And yet, although I'm only 64 kilograms, it's a joy for me to scull, even though it will accommodate a real heavyweight. I really enjoyed sculling this boat, and I'm sure lots of other people will. If an obese person gets into a rowing boat, goes off up the river or out to sea, nobody's watching them exercising, so they don't need to be embarrassed about their bodies, which I'm sure if you propose to them going down to the local gym, they would be embarrassed. So this is the solution that I see. It's not for everybody, obviously, because not everybody has access to water, but for a lot of people, it's a good solution. So do you go down to the gym and work out every night, Steve?
No.
That's the last thing I do, is to go down to the gym. I often get asked that, actually. No, I just go sculling. My body is optimised for sculling because I go sculling. And this is what people need to be doing. They need to be exercising, but it needs to be a joy, so that you look forward to it. It's not something that you dread. Oh, I've got to go down the gym. Oh, God, the doctor said I had to work out. No. It's got to be, oh wow, I'm going to go sculling now. But rowing in the sort of boat that I race in is not accessible to the average person in the street, because it requires a higher level of expertise. And balancing one of these boats is a difficult skill, takes a long time to learn. But balancing the sort of boats that I sell, that's easy. And that's why these sort of boats are accessible to all and sundry, and why I feel that recreational rowing like this is a good way for people to get in shape and to lose weight and to help tackle the obesity crisis that we have, that's breaking the National Health Service. You know, it's become socially unacceptable to smoke now, isn't it, really? And the same thing needs to happen with overeating. I do hate to see people who are obese eating cream cakes. You know, it just drives me mad. So we need to do something about it. And this is my little bit. So where can people get one of these boats, Steve?
Well, the best place to start is on my website, ahoy-boats.biz.
Well, thanks for coming into the studio, Steve. It's been a pleasure talking with you.
Not at all. The pleasure's been all mine.
And that's all we have time for today, ladies and gentlemen.